Let us study addition of angular momentum in quantum mechanics. In quantum mechanics, we have an intrinsic angular momentum, which is spin angular momentum. And this does not have any classical analogy. Addition of angular momentum is extremely important in quantum mechanics, because if we want to study quantum mechanical systems, for example, nucleus, or say for many electron systems, for example, in oxygen 8-16, we have 8 electrons orbiting around the nucleus, and each electron will have its own angular momentum. So we need to add those angular momentum. They have their own spins. Electron is a spin half particle, so we need to add their spins too. And if we include their space degrees of freedom, momenta is also a space degrees of freedom. Space and momenta, position and momenta, they are both space degree of freedom. And this is the spin degree of freedom. So if we take into account both of this, space and spin, then the wave function, the eigenket of the system can be written like this. This is the space part, this is spin part. This eigenstate will give me spin values plus h cross by 2 for spin up particle, minus h cross by 2 for spin down particle. One thing I would like to say that if we consider the space which is spanned by this eigenstate, this state vector, then any operator within that space will commute with any operator which lies in the space spanned by this state vectors. Now we will have this J operator, which is basically summation of orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. And this what we call the rotation generator, because it generates a rotation. If we apply this on a system, it undergoes some rotation, and if the angle of that rotation is phi, just for the time being I'm taking it phi, so the operator which involves the rotation operator, rotation generator, will look like this. And as L and S commutes, that is orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum, as they commute, so we can write the operator in terms of angular and space part. We may write this eigenket including space and spin like this, and we may write also like this. This is equal to this. And we may write the wave function in this column matrix also, in the form of this column matrix also. This is plus for spin up particle, this is minus for spin down particle. This defines this chi plus x mod square. This defines the probability density to find the particle in the spin up state. Now we may use, instead of x or instead of chi x ket, instead of this basis, we may use this basis also, because this is very convenient to handle with, because it contains all the quantum numbers. And this is the eigenstate of L square operator, which gives this eigenvalue L into L plus 1 h cross square. And this is Lz, z component of the orbital angular momentum, and eigenvalue is m h cross. For spin, the state will be plus minus this one, this will be the eigenket, and s square is the spin operator, s z is the z value of the angular momentum operator, spin angular momentum operator. Now, instead of these bases, I may use the states of J square L square, A square, and JZ also. Which means that if we expand a state vector of a particle which has a spin, then we may use the eigenstates of L square, S square, LZ, and SZ, or we may simultaneously use the eigenstates of J square, JZ, L square, and A square to define the state vector of the same particle with spin. Let us discuss a system of two spin half particles, that is two fermions. If they are having spin half each, then their total spin angular momentum S will be equal to S1 plus S2. And this relation 1 can be written like relation 2 also. This symbol, this cross circle inside a circle, this is a symbol of matrix multiplication. This is actually symbolizes tensor multiplication, but I am not going to the complexity of tensors, and that is also beyond the scope of this lecture. We may now think this as matrix multiplication. This is spin. This is an observable, and we can have operator corresponding to an observable, and operators are represented by matrix. We know that this is identity operator, so this is another matrix. This is identity operator of secondary electron, corresponding to secondary electron, and this is identity operator corresponding to first electron. Actually, this is the identity operator in the spin space of the first electron. And this is the identity operator in the spin space of the second electron. So this is nothing but spin multiplication. And as the multiplication of matrix is its order dependent, order is important in matrix multiplication. So this identity operators must be written like this. This is not just one. So that we can have it, we can write it anywhere. Now we have, for two electrons, we can have S1x, that is x component of spin 1, and y component of spin of the second electrons. They must commute it with each other, that is quite obvious. And for first electron and second electron, these relationships hold. And these are represented by equation 4. From 3 and 4, we can write this as a consequence. And these are the eigenvalues corresponding to S square operator, SZ operator, S1Z operator, S2Z operator. Now we can write an arbitrary spin state of these two electrons in two representations. In one representation, we may use the eigenstates of S square and SZ as basis. And in other representation, we may have eigenstates of S1Z and S2Z as basis. First, I will take this representation, this M1, M2 representation. These are the eigenkates of this S1 and S2, S1Z and S2Z. That's why M1, M2 is here. And in this representation, the eigenkates are like this. This represents that both particles are spin up. This is one spin up, one spin down, which means M1 value is plus half here, M2 value is minus half here. For this one, M1 is minus half here and M2 is plus half. For this eigenstate, M1, M2 both are minus half, and for this one, it is written already. Now, let us take this representation also. This is a basis formed by the eigenvectors of S square and SZ. Now, if we have two spin half particles and angular spin angular momentum is a vector quantity. So when spin half angular momentum and spin half angular momentum, they add vectorially, we can have 1 or 0. If this total angular momentum equal to 1, then we will have 3 projections of this vector, 1, plus 1, minus 1 and 0. This state is called spin triplet, because corresponding to s equal to 1, we will have 3 m values. We may write this as ms also. In some literature and books, it is written as ms also, m suffix s, which means projection of the spin angular momentum operator. This is a scalar quantity. And if I take s equal to 0, then only one projection can be taken into account, m equal to 0, plus 1 and minus 1 are meaningless here, because the angular momentum is 0 itself here. And this is a single state, so this is called spin singlet. Let us define ladder operators for spin. We have studied lots of things about ladder operators in my previous videos. This ladder operator s minus, this will lower the m values, and this can be written as a summation of s1 minus and s2 minus, and this can be further written like this, that is s1 minus equal to s1x minus is1y. Just like when we defined ladder operators with j, we defined j plus minus, and j plus minus was combination of jx and ijy. I mean jx and jy with I in front of the y component. So this is 8. This s1 minus, this will act on m1 value, that is m value for spin 1, and this will act on the m value of the second particle. And this is how all the states look like. We have s equal to 1, m equal to 1, both are plus 1, m values are plus, so it's m1 is plus, m2 is plus. Similarly, we have found the other states. These are superposed state. This is quantum mechanical superposition, this one and this one. Now let me operate this s minus on this state, s equal to 1, m equal to 1. If we apply s minus on this state, we'll get this one. Operating s minus on s equal to 1, m equal to 1, we'll lower the m value by 1, because it's a minus, and the eigenvalue will be s plus m, and s minus m plus 1 to the power half. This is quite standard way to write this operation. And while s1 minus acting on this plus plus state, it will lower the m value of first particle, so this plus is now minus, and in this term s2 plus is acting on this second particle only, will never act on this first particle, so this spin is now spin down instead of spin half, that's spin up. That's why I have written this as plus minus. And this is my state s1 m0, which is a superposition of these two states, and this is the equation 9b. Now let me tell you one thing I would just like to mention here. Later I will derive the coefficients. These coefficients, these are called Clebsch-Gordan coefficients. These are the simplest forms of Clebsch-Gordan coefficients. These coefficients are actually a bridge between the basis of SM and this M1, M2 basis.